Once again, it's on. Hey, my name is Lorenzo Ice-T Thomas of the Sports Brothers, and it's now time to talk some Miami Dolphins football. I want to thank you for tuning into the show because today, well, we're going to take a look back at how the Miami Dolphins organization has progressed over the last 2 years and how we've proceeded this year. And after the NFL schedule was released, oh boy, we can see that our Miami Dolphins' first 5 games, ooh, they're going to be challenging. But you remember, after the draft, the experts and analysts, boy, they were raining compliments like Stephen Curry threes. I mean, they are now singing the praises of Chris Greer and Brian Flores. But it was not too long ago, so many people were not down with the Dolphins program. I mean, a lot of players wanted to jump ship. Now, I've been a Dolph fan longer than most. I mean, there are levels to this, and I've earned the right to clap back when I feel necessary. I'm a diehard Dolph fan who doesn't forget. And I live by the Brian Flores phrase that may sound like a diss, but looking back now, many of you didn't trust the process.
Trust the process.
What are your thoughts on what they're doing in Miami?
It's unethical and morally reprehensible, as far as I'm concerned, because we understand how dangerous football is as a game. Putting guys out there in this type of danger is a problem, but you can put that aside. I think as an employer, you have an obligation to provide as safe a working environment as you can, and also provide the people an opportunity to succeed. These young men have committed their lives to getting to the NFL, and the expectation is once you get to the NFL, the team will do the very best that they can do to make sure you succeed. They are not doing this there, and that's not fair because these guys are physically paying the price. These guys are putting bad film on tape because they're not trying to win, and it's going to shorten their careers, and you know who's going to benefit from them? The owner and the general managers and maybe the potential future coach. These guys are going to benefit from it. They're going to be out of the league having their careers ruined by a selfish team like the Dolphins.
Wow, he said selfish team like the Dolphins. Now, do you think we were a selfish team? Yes, we let Ryan Tannehill go after 7 years and no playoff wins. Yes, we traded away Kenyon Drake, who just didn't fit. And instead of extending and signing him to a big contract, we traded Laremy Tunsil and Kenny Stills for draft capital. While the experts and some fans were screaming, "What are you doing?" Chris Greer was thrilled to continue to stack the draft chips and wheel and deal as if he was Warren Buffett. To date, Chris Greer has made 28 deals in 28 months. And you must have forgot that Coach Flo was a former scout who has an eye for talent. And you, just like me, we should continue to trust the process because most Dolphin fans, like I, have been there every step of the way. Once again, it's on. Hey, it's the Sports Brothers. I'm Lorenzo Thomas.
Jeff Fox on the box.
And we're coming at you from Hard Rock Stadium, where it's the kickoff of the 100th year for the NFL, and of course the kickoff weekend for the Miami Dolphins as the Baltimore Ravens come to town, as they always, with a huge fan base and a huge final score here at Hard Rock. Boy, it wasn't even close from the gate. 59-10.
Your thoughts today about the Miami Dolphins?
Brutal. It was brutal, Lorenzo.
What was it that you weren't seeing in week one that you hope to see from this point forward?
I think there's a lot of factors here.
Week two in the NFL, and the conclusion of the entire NFL season is already in. The Miami Dolphins are predicted to go 0-16, and the visiting team, well, they've already been crowned Super Bowl champion.
Brian, why did it change? You know, we felt like we needed to make that move. I felt that way. I think I'm always going to do what's in the best interest of the Miami Dolphins.
The Miami Dolphins have won 5 of the last 6 against the New England Patriots. Tom Brady has struggled, and the Dolphins have won the previous 2 games here at Hard Rock Stadium against the Patriots.
I hope Brian Flores can keep a hold of his locker room, because at the end of the game, it looked to me like the Miami Dolphins are winning. Wow. One thing you don't want your team to do is quit.
You know we only got one mission here. Back at the rock.
Play hard. They may have more talent than you.
Well, we have the Dallas Cowboys coming up, San Diego Chargers after that, and then the bye. And then after the bye, the team will have a chance to regroup, and we do have a couple of games against the New York Jets who may be playing without Sam Donald.
Yep.
times on 3-3, to the band, one more time. Swag on three, swag on three, 1, 2, 3.
Swag. I mean, a legitimate argument could be made that there's a college team that could be done. This might be the worst football team in the NFL.
That's
I
the one out there.
They are atrocious. And it's hard for me to say that because we're general manager, Brian Flores, African American general manager, head coach. You don't see that too often in the National Football League. We recognize that they rebuild and we got that. But they made some good moves in terms of first round picks they acquired. But this is one of the most atrocious teams that I've ever seen. Combine that with the fact that half of them look like they don't even want to be there. That's one thing, you know, they don't want to see.
If I were a Dolphins player, I would demand a trade.
Minka Fitzpatrick is reportedly frustrated and has requested a trade.
With the 11th
Minka Fitzpatrick,
the 2018 NFL draft,
picks off Ryan Fitzpatrick twice.
Minka Fitzpatrick.
Today, he had an interception for 96 yards.
I think tanking has no place in the NFL. These players are putting their bodies and their minds on the line for an organization that is actively working against
them. I have faith in this Dolphin organization. I know what they're doing. You Dolphin fans know what they're doing as well.
Right.
They're preparing you for the future. It just seems that the stars were aligned.
Yeah.
When the clock hits zero,
the whole stadium erupted in joy.
For the first time in 10 games,
church.
This was the first time the Dolphins had won since the Miami Miracle when Kenyon Drake scored right here in this end zone.
Defensive, you kind of had a feeling today was going to be the day.
Dolphins win.
Mike Gesicki.
If I were a Dolphins season ticket holder, I would demand a refund. And if I were commissioner of the NFL, I would conduct an investigation. And if I found evidence that the Dolphins front office is colluding to tank, I would take away their first round pick.
We didn't listen to the haters. They stayed together. They trusted one another. Starting the season 0-7 and finishing 5-4 over the last 9 games. And to top it off, defeating the New England Patriots and keeping them from getting a first round bye.
Hey, what can I say, dog?
Hey,
what can we say, dog?
How you finish, baby?
That's how you in this? You finish. That's how you in it, right here.
Yeah.
You guys just kept working your ass off, all right? And you're seeing the fruits of that labor, all right?
Yeah.
The process, the preparation, all that it counts, all right? So you get moments like this, that hard work, all right? There's joy in hard work, and this is it right here. I'm just telling you that right now. There's joy in hard work. This is it, all right? And this is just the beginning. Trust me on that one, all right? Bring it up.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And that's one, baby.
Oh, yeah.
One time for the 19, baby.
Believe, man.
How about them Dolphins, fellas? Yeah. Dolphins on 3. 1, 2, 3.
Go.
You got to love it. Now, a team can build through the draft and add pieces in free agency to field a team that can compete. And that's exactly what the Dolphins did this past season. Yes, the Dolphins rebuild is way ahead of schedule. And there are quite a few people should take time out to apologize for some of the things that were said at the beginning of the season. You got to remember, it's a marathon, not a sprint. And with 3 first round picks in the 2020 draft, I can see and you can see too that Chris Greer and Brian Flores are far from finished.
With the 5th pick.
2,000 on the Miami Dolphins, 2,000 surrounding us.
Travel 2,000 kilometers
to hang out with us. What's up, Danger?
Quarterback, Alabama.
What's up, Danger?
Let me see you go hard. Didn't know they doubted us. Makes it that more marvelous. Sign them up, cause ominous vibes and I get synonymous. What's up, Danger? Hey, don't be a stranger. Cause I like high chances that I might lose. I like it all on the edge, just like you. Hey, I like tall buildings so I can leap off of them. I go hard with it no matter how dark.
I'm insane, but on my toes, I could keep the world balanced on my nose. I had a slumber party with all my foes. Now I wear them like a badge on all my clothes. If I'm crazy, I'm on my own. If I'm waiting, it's on my phone. If I sound lazy, just ignore my tone. Cause I'm always gonna answer when you call my phone. Like, what's up, Danger? Like, what's up, Danger? We'll be right back. blindfold on. Mama always asking, where did I go wrong? What's up, danger? What's up, danger? Travel 200 miles, I'm knocking at your door. And I don't really care if you ain't done wrong. Come on, what's up, danger? Don't be a stranger. I like it when drummer grooves, I want their change. I like it when there's turbulence on my airplanes. I like it when I sense things that I can't see yet. Swimming with sharks when they ain't feed yet. Cause I like high chances that I might lose. I like it all on the edge just like you. Ay, I like tall buildings, sparkling.
Jones. Signed up in free agency and teamed up with Xavier Howard to have the best cornerback tandem in the NFL.
Kyle Van Noy.
He brought outstanding leadership.
Jordan Howard. Shaq Lawson. Process.
Even though the Miami Dolphins may have overspent last year in free agency, I know. But don't forget how successful this team was. 10 wins they won last year. And now Chris Greer can sign the free agency the way he wants to. I mean, he doesn't have to spend as much money anymore. Why? Because all he has to do is show the players this clip. Because all the ballers want a coach who has his back.
Fight, James. Now we got a ball. They're coming off the sidelines from Miami.
You don't want to do that.
Miami's bench has emptied.
You gotta love our coach. After starting 0-7, the Miami Dolphins have won 15 of their last 25 games. As the roster turns, all of this draft capital that they have obtained must hope that they turn these picks into future Pro Bowl players and significant contributors to the future of the Miami Dolphins. I'm ready to go. Talk to them, coach.
Ready to go.
We scoured free agency. We have a pretty good feel for the types of guys we're looking for.
Touchdown, Will Fuller.
And he is dropped right there. Duke Riley making the stop.
Well, what a job concentrating by number 27, Justin Colvin. He's been one of the better slot corners in the league.
Ball taken out of his hands, and it's caught in the air by Jenkins.
Bernardrick McKinney, number 55, with the initial contact.
He ran into a wall.
I want to point out a guy who flies under the radar a little bit, and that's center Matt Skura.
DJ Fluker picked up in free agency.
Down he goes! What a game Adam Butler's had today.
Well, he's finally taken down Brennan Scarlett again.
The Dolphins bringing in Jacoby Brissett. 1 year deal.
Hand off here. That is Brown for the touchdown.
It's complete to Seaton Carter, his tight end.
The Miami Dolphins are agreeing to terms on a deal with punter Michael Pilardi.
What's up, Miami? Jason McCourty checking in here from the facility down here. You see where I'm at in Miami. I got my Miami gear on. I'm ready. I'm ready to go to work. I'm ready to hydrate and get ready for this heat. Let's go, fellas. Fins up.
The Miami Dolphins select.
Well protected again. Waddle for another touchdown.
And he was swarmed. Jalen Phillips. Javon Holland comes up with another.
All he does is keep his body and the defender's body away from the quarterback.
Hunter Long has the touchdown for Boston College.
Hey, this is a kid who can move a little bit, get upfield.
And here's Jared Dokes. He's got a lot of running room in front of him.
Well, you can see at number six, the Dolphins picked the perfect player. And Jalen did hug his family. Take a look. He did. And I love the way Tua reacted to his boy getting selected. J-Dub!
What they doing now, y'all?
Yes, sir. Deep and Will Waddle has got.
Ooh, that boy is fast. He's going to be throwing to his former teammate in college. Woo! And of course, talking about explosive, man, Jalen Phillips. And the coach had a chance to call him and talk to him, too.
Jalen, Coach Flo here.
This is great.
What's up? Congratulations. We're excited. We are. Everyone's jumping up and down. We're excited to have you. We're kind of holding our breath there a little bit. But, gotcha. We're excited. We got a lot of faith in you. So, hey, congratulations. All right? Congratulations. Welcome to the Dolphins.
Pressure Lawrence, who escapes. Can he get there with his legs?
Let him run down Trevor.
See the first appearance from the chain.
Yes, we will definitely see the turnover chain at the Rock. And I'm just wondering, will you see Holland or Phillips rocking the chain? But Chris Greer, he keeps picking these gems.
You doing good?
Oh, this is funny, if you haven't seen this.
We're on the clock here, so we're going to make you Miami Dolphin, all right? I hear everyone screaming. I said, we're going to make you Miami Dolphins.
Too funny.
For the Miami Dolphins, Javon.
Nix has time and launches downfield. Jump ball intercepted. Picked off by Javon Holland.
Holland's a pro. He's an NFL player that's a safety but can cover. That's why they'll leave him out there.
56th pick with the 241st.
244th pick.
I like what they're putting together down in Miami.
I just feel so blessed to even have this opportunity.
I love what this team is about.
It's good to be a Dolphin.
It was just beyond anyone's possible dreams. It was
Shout out to Big E, who won the Miami Dolphins Fan of the Year. He represented big time at the NFL Draft. Now, I got to move out of the way for this one because, of course, you know, camp started. Rookie camp is crazy. So you can see, pick after pick, the Dolphins will continue to build something special. And I believe this team is ready to take the next step. And it was reported that about 70 players, over 70 players, showed up to voluntary camp. And I think that's a sign that everyone is all in. And since taking over as general manager with full power, 28 months, Greer has made 28 trades. That is a lot. And even Dallas Cowboy, former Miami Dolphins and Dallas Cowboy coach Jimmy Johnson approved of Greer's aggressive maneuvering. And Jimmy said he liked his approach. And he said, you know, you can play it safe and be good, or you can take chances and be great. Now that the Dolphins have a new offense and a great defense and a coaching staff that has earned the respect of the entire NFL. I don't think, you know, we forgot about 2019 and some of the things that people said about the Dolphins. And as for me, Lorenzo Ice-T Thomas, a season ticket holder with exclusive on-field coverage and local insight as a professional broadcaster with perspective that could be more in-depth than some of the national analysts. Yes. Thus, from this point on, if I don't agree with what I'm hearing, I'll just do another segment of, this is what I would have said. Until next time, trust the process.